Before we jump into preparing a bank reconciliation, we're first going to work through the alternate exercise 6-8 and look at some common examples. For example, the first item is going to be interest on the cash balance. Work through some common examples of items that may or may not be shown on the bank reconciliation, and if they are, whether or not they affect the bank balance, and if so, is it an addition or subtraction? And similar, the book balance, again, do we add or deduct? So interest on our cash balance, that's something the bank's already fully aware of. After all, they're the ones who provided interest on your checking or savings account, whatever it might be. So there's no adjustment necessary on the bank balance. It's already reflected in your current balance. On the other hand, it's likely something you or the company that you're preparing this for hasn't yet adjusted in their books. Interest is going to be an addition or add to your book balance, and because we're talking about the cash account, which is an asset where we would debit cash for interest on our cash balance. Of course, we mentioned it's affecting the book balance, so this is something that would be shown on our bank reconciliation. Our second item is going to be bank service charges. Maybe perhaps you've ordered some new checks for the bank, and maybe there's a $20-$25 charge. So this is something, again, the bank's already fully aware of. They're the ones who charged you this funds, so there's no adjustment necessary on the bank side. However, on the book side, it's likely something you weren't aware of, the charge at this particular point. Now you've got the bank statement, and you've got the debit memorandum that indicates what exact fee that they're going to charge. So you're going to subtract it, because this is less cash that you're going to have on your book balance. And because we're reducing cash, which is an asset, we would credit it. This is also shown on our bank reconciliation. The next item is going to be outstanding checks. What we mean by that is checks the company or you or whoever has already prepared. Maybe you've even stuck them in the mail, but they haven't yet arrived at their destination, or even if they have, they haven't yet cleared against the bank account. So from the bank's perspective, they're not aware of them yet. You're aware of them on the book side, but the bank's not yet aware of them. So we would have to deduct them from the bank balance. Again, already properly reflected on the books. After all, you're the one who prepared them, so you've already credited cash and debited some type of asset or expense account. Again, this is shown on the bank reconciliation as a deduction of the bank balance. Our next item is going to be credit memos. This is where things get confusing, is banking and accounting use debit and credit memos, the terminology differently. Because your bank balance is a liability from the bank's perspective, keep in mind, it's not their money. They have to provide it to you at any point in time. It's a liability. So if we're increasing a liability, we credit it. So credit memo would be considered something that would add to your balance in your account. A debit memo, remember, a debit reduces liability, would deduct from it. Again, this is something that the bank's already full aware of. They provided the credit memorandum to increase your account. So whether that might be interest income or a note they collected on your behalf, they're already aware of it, so nothing needed from the bank balance. On the other hand, it's something not yet properly reflected in the books, so we're going to have to add it by debiting cash. Again, this is shown on the bank reconciliation. Our fifth item is going to be NSF checks. So non-sufficient funds. So it's something you got a check from a customer, you debited cash, maybe credited accounts receivable on the book side, you went and deposited the bank. I mean, after all, you felt like they had funds in their account. The bank initially put the funds in your account, but unfortunately, this particular company didn't have sufficient funds. So the bank has come through and taken those funds back out of your account. The bank's already fully aware of this. They're notifying you, so no adjustment needed on the bank side. On the other hand, you are going to have to adjust your books. You previously debited cash. You're going to have to come through and deduct this from the book balance and credit cash. Again, this is another item shown on the bank reconciliation. The last item that I'm going to work through is going to be a little bit more complicated. Number 6 starts out like number 3 in that it mentions outstanding checks. So you think, oh, let's jump into this. This is going to be a deduction for the bank side. But there's another stipulation. Outstanding checks from the prior month. So when we did the prior month bank reconciliation, here were some checks that hadn't yet cleared the bank. So we would have deducted them from our bank balance. On the other hand, we're fast forwarding another month. Those same outstanding checks for the prior month now have actually cleared the bank. So maybe it was something, you know, that on the 29th of the month, we issued some checks, put them in the mail. Now they finally arrived at their destination and cleared the bank. They're no longer outstanding. This is no longer an adjustment to our bank balance. It was the prior month, but they're no longer outstanding. They've cleared the bank. They've reduced the bank balance already, so not an adjustment. Also, in the prior month, we already properly reflected those in the books, so no adjustment to our book balance. So this is one item that would not be shown on our bank reconciliation. Again, these are not the only items you can expect to be adjustments, but hopefully this gives you a flavor of items before you jump into this problem.